What up, everybody? This is Ace69, also known as Ace69 Gamer, on my other awesome mobile gaming YouTube channel, baby. Yeah. Today, on this episode of Ace69 Vlogs, I did something cringy. I was a little nervous, but I had to do career day. I signed up for career day at my daughter's elementary school. I didn't even get her class, but it's all good. I was able to talk to two classes. It was a little cringeworthy at first. The kids were awesome. They had many questions. They had a great time. They loved it. I feel they loved it. But I was a little cringeworthy because I was nervous. And the first class that I went to, it was all third graders. Both classes were third graders, but the first class I went to, I was a little nervous, and it was awesome, man. It was awesome. I was able to get my point across. I was able to talk to them. I was able to answer the questions. But the second time, the second class that I went to was even better, because I was able to relax a little bit more. I wasn't able to record on that one, so I only recorded the first session. The second session, I wasn't able to record. But I was able to let them know about my channel, so they know about it, and they got all excited when they heard I was a YouTuber that I do this for as a hobby. They were like, "Oh my God, you're a YouTuber! What's your channel? Oh my God!" I was like, "Yeah, I do gaming channels. I do vlogs." They're like, "What is this? So I can subscribe? Oh my God!" And I gave it to them, and they were awesome, man. So if you were in that class, either of that class, and you're watching this video, thank you. Thumbs up, man. You guys were awesome. You all had great questions. You all were interested in my career. Really thank you from the bottom of my heart. I hope I didn't bore you. I hope you learned something. Hope you let your friends know that a YouTuber was in your class. But, yeah, man. It was awesome experience. I loved it. The people there were awesome. Even the staff was awesome. Teachers, you guys were awesome. Thank you guys for everything. I was able to tell everyone about my job and tell everyone how crazy it kind of gets at my job. But I don't think I would change it for the world, because I'm able to help a lot of people. And they were happy that I was there. They were happy that I told them about myself. I told them my family from Guatemala, and that, you know, I know how everything is right here, and I know how everything is because I grew up in LA. You know what I mean? So, you know, it is what it is. I grew up here and I'm still here, but I'm still working hard, and they loved it. They loved knowing that I was one of them. And yeah, man, just want to say thank you all. Hope you enjoy this video. A little cringe worthy. The teacher was the one recording, and thank you for that teacher for recording that video. If you enjoyed this video, please give a like. Make sure you comment, subscribe, share for more. Hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'm sorry if the audio is a little low. Like I said, she was the one recording, I wasn't the one recording. So I did my best. Hope I don't bore you to death. Watch this whole video, and just want to say the kids are our future, man. And I just hope you guys learn something. If you do want to be security guards, like I said, you gotta work hard. You gotta make sure you guys love to help people, and teamwork. And check out my Ace69 Gamer. And I just uploaded a video. Thank you, everyone. That is it for today. Watch the whole video. Hope you guys enjoy it. Join the notification squad for more awesome content on this channel. Ace69 out. Woo!
My company is
packed with security. Alright. Let me tell you a little bit about my workplace, what I do, and a lot of different things that can maybe help you out. Say, why did I choose this occupation? Easy. I like to help people. If you like to help people out, this is an awesome career. You see, every day at work, I experience a lot of many different things. Sometimes good, sometimes a little bad. But every day is a new day. Every day is different. There's a lot of opportunities in security guard. You can work at special events, concerts. You can work at buildings like what I do. I've done both. I've done concerts. I've done Coachella. I've done different concerts for pop stars and rap stars. All that. I've done all that. But I like the job where I'm at. There's a lot of different opportunities. You can always move up the ladder. There's always opportunities. You're always looking for new clients. Just letting you guys know. What I learned in school that helps me do my job. I learned how to deal with people, how to de-escalate bad situations. Sometimes when you work security guards, especially where I work, which is in downtown where a lot of homeless people live, sometimes they get mad, right? And they try to come at you. They try to they think it's your fault. You're just doing your job, right? So the best thing to do is talk to them. Do not fight with them. Best thing to do is just be, hi, I'm just a security guard, doing my job. How can I help you? All I want to do is help you, right? Try to talk to them. Try to find out what's the problem. Why are they upset? What's going on in their lives? Rather than fighting with them, what's going on and how different ways you can help. That's all you do. Okay. Skills you need for this occupation. Patience. A lot of patience. You need patience. Because sometimes there's people that they want everything at the moment. Sometimes you can do it, sometimes you can't. There's certain ways you can talk to them and let them know, look, lunchtime is not yet, you gotta wait. Or, you know what, you can't talk to this person's in a meeting. You gotta wait a couple minutes. But while you wait, how about you talk to me and let's see, maybe I can help you out in another way. Maybe I can direct you to someone else that can help you out while this person is busy, right? Also, people skills. You can't get upset at every little thing. You gotta be able to handle people. You gotta be able to talk to them, right? So the temper. Temper is a big thing when you be a security guard. Because sometimes there's people that are gonna yell at you, scream at you, tell you things, and you can't take it personal. Because it's not your fault. Sometimes they're just going through a lot of things and they just want to take it out of you. So what you do, never take anything personal. You talk to them and be like, look, I know you're mad, right? I know you're mad. But the best thing to do is not yell. Because after that, we might have to go to the police. After that, we might have to escort you out. You don't want that. So the best thing to do is just relax. Talk to me, it's not my fault. I find ways to maybe make your day a little bit better. You need some water, you need a little cup of coffee, you know, something to calm him down, calm the person down. Teamwork, you have to work in a team. When you're a guard, sometimes things happen, and you need to make sure your team has your back. It's just like a police officer. You never see a police officer go to somewhere to a call by themselves. Am I correct?
Yes.
you gotta have a team. You gotta have backup. And you gotta trust them, and they have to trust you. So you know that if you call, they're right there with you. And the same thing, if they call, if someone from your team calls and they need your help, you gotta respond. You gotta be quick on your feet and make sure you know the ways to get there as quick as possible. Know the shortcuts. Learn the shortcuts. Working as a team helps out a lot. Sometimes there's more than one person upset. Sometimes there's more than one person that is sick that needs to go to the hospital. So you can't do it by yourself. Sometimes someone needs just faints. And it's a big person, you can't carry that person. So maybe you need your teammate to help you out. So teamwork is very big when it comes to security. I'm gonna give you a description of a typical day at my job. So I clock in. The first thing I do, I grab a clicker, which is a clicker to a gate in the back of the building where people can park. Every single day when someone calls into the radio, hey, you gotta open the gate for somebody. Then I go to the back, click on the clicker, they can come in, come out, close the gate. That's one of the main things that happens. Then, I help out other officers. Like I said, teamwork. Teamwork is big when you're a security guard. We deal with lunches and dinners. We don't serve them, but we patrol when people are coming in. There's three different times that people come in. There's a men's program, which is the people that are trying to get help. They're in the program for the building. They have different situations that they work through, try to get jobs, try to get a home, stuff like that. They have different programs, so they're in the program. There's families, like single mothers that have kids, single fathers. There's men that don't have any kids, but they're homeless, they need somewhere to stay. There's women that don't have kids as well, that are homeless and need somewhere to stay, and they're trying to get help. Okay, and we assist the cooks, we assist the people that are volunteering. We make sure they're safe. We have to make sure they're safe. If there's any situation, there's different codes that we use to try to get to the situation that's going on. Okay, if there's a fight, we gotta make sure, try to control that and fix it. Maybe have to take someone out, maybe just calm them down. Whatever the situation, we gotta attend to as quick as possible before it escalates. You do not want it to escalate. You do not want others to get upset. So you gotta do it as quick as possible. We deal with bag searches. There are certain times that we have to search people's bags, just to make sure that everyone in that building is safe. We got to make sure that everyone is safe. We check their bags, make sure there's no contrabands, make sure there's no weapons, make sure there's no anything that's not allowed. Okay? It's our job to keep everyone in that building safe. Let's see. We also, we're open to the public from 12 to 3. So from by 12 to 3, the best thing to do is if you're trying to live there or trying to get a bed there for the night, at least for one day, for a week, those are the times that people can go in and try to get a ticket. After 3 o'clock, we close, and the only ones allowed are the people that have a bed ticket. We call it a bed ticket. Doesn't matter if it's for just one night, doesn't matter if it's for a week, couple of months, you gotta have a bed ticket. If not, we have to take you out. We start checking everyone's ticket. If you have a ticket, you can stay. If you don't, we're gonna have to ask you to leave. And we make sure everyone has a ticket. okay? To make sure every man, women, child, everyone has a ticket. So you can live, so you can stay there the night. Okay? Let's see. Going to work. Bonus clip.
Then that's what I'm groomed in. You got my pictures on the wall and you're booming. Girls be complaining, you keep me booming. But girls like that wanna listen to Pat Boone. Use a college girl, but that don't stop you from doing. Come and see the dog in the hood near you.
Ace69 Gamer, Ace69 Blows.
Nothing.
Woo!
I smack up the world if they go to you. Cause baby girl, you're so beautiful.
Girl. Time to go to work. Woo!